Hello and welcome to the Daily Mill for Saturday, the 25th of May 2024. In today's Millwall News, we start off with this from the southernnews.co.uk. Millwall military veterans to finish 44 kilometre hike with football match. Gurkhas will marshal the weary trekkers. Oh my goodness, what's going on here then? Well, Millwall military veterans will complete a 44-kilometre nighttime hike marshalled by Gurkhas to raise money for the Royal British Legion. Members of the newly formed Millwall Military Veteran Football Club will march with football equipment slung over their backs, concluding the walk with a five-a-side match. Tommy's D-Day Trek, a fundraising challenge marking the D-Day landing's 80th anniversary, will go through the Kent countryside on Friday, June the 7th. Joined by Millwall Community Trust staff, trekkers set off at midnight, travelling through villages, fields and woodland. The route concludes at the historic Chilham Castle, with weary trekkers enjoying a hard-earned kickabout at the end. I don't think that's much enjoyment in that. I mean, you've just walked 44 kilometres. Whatever that is, what's that in miles? Is that 25 miles or something like that? And then you have to have a match at the end of it. Blimey. Breakfast will be included along the route to keep participants fully fueled midway through the trek. Royal British Legion Industries, RBLI, is a national charity since 1919. They've provided crucial accommodation, welfare and employment support to injured veterans and people with disabilities. To donate to the cause, just click on their Just Giving page, which is a Millwall Community Trust. And we've got more on this here. This is from millwallfc.co.uk. Tommy's D-Day Trek. I saw this and I thought, well, are they asking for people to do this? Because this is quite a thing. But no, it's the people. It's like the, is it Major Tom? Colonel Tom? Major Tom? Not David Bowie Major Tom. The old geezer who walked around the care home during COVID to raise money. So it's like they're doing it and then you kind of sponsor them to do it. You give money because they're doing it. So yeah, this is from millwallfc.co.uk. Millwall Veterans and Millwall Community Trust staff as part of the Millwall Military Veterans Football Program and Military Veteran Football Club are taking part in Tommy's D-Day by trekking from midnight through the North Downs in Kent to raise vital funds to support Royal British Legion Industries. Tommy's D-Day trek is a fundraising challenge designed to mark the 80th anniversary of the D-Day landings in 1944. The trek starts at midnight at the end of Friday the 7th of June 2024 and will go through the night until Saturday the 8th of June at 9 a.m. Oh, it doesn't mention here, well, why are they doing it overnight? Is that because of the D-Day landings? I'm assuming they travelled overnight on the boats and then landed in the daytime. I imagine like right now, like if you're awake at 4 a.m. you can see the sky does get kind of like a light blue, so I imagine by June it'll be quite bright at that time in the morning. So is that how they did it, and is that why they're running walking overnight? But yeah, 44 kilometers, that's some distance as well, isn't that? I think the M25 is like 60 kilometers wide, is it not? Well, north to south, I think. It's further east to west. I think north to south, it might be like 60 kilometres or 60 miles, something like that. That's nothing to be sniffed at. The route will be marshalled by the Gurkhas and breakfast will be included along the route to keep participants fully fueled midway through the trek. See, it says your trek, like they're asking people to do it. Following this monumental effort, military veterans and Millwall Community Trust staff, as part of the Millwall Military Veterans Football Program and Millwall and Military Veteran Football Club, will go one step further and finish the day with a hard-earned five-a-side match after carrying the football equipment needed the full route. So there you go. And like I said, if you go to either the Southern News or millwallfc.co.uk, you can see their donate, and their donate is justgiving.com. Millwall Community Trust, and you can find it from there. Now, in yesterday's video, there's not a lot going on today, as I mentioned that. There's one more thing I'm going to mention, and that's going to be it. Yesterday's video, talking about the attendances at Millwall, everyone quite rightly, obviously, So congratulating everyone at Millwall. Oh, well done. You've done all this stuff. You're sending out all these emails. You're doing this kind of. You've been doing stuff behind the scenes, the away memberships and stuff. But what we're seeing, I think it's bigger than that. Like obviously, you need to be on the ball, and you need to strike when the iron is hot. But there are larger geopolitical, economical, whatever it is, things going on because it's not just Millwall, it's across the entire EFL system. Championship, League One, League Two. Obviously, some clubs will be doing better than others, but English Football League crowds hit a 70-year high. So it's the whole league is doing fantastic. So the English Football League has recorded its highest aggregate attendance for nearly 70 years. It racked up a total attendance of 19.8 million in the 22-23 season, the biggest since the 53-54 season. This is a new story. I don't know. No, this is an old story. Ah, they got me. You know what? I fucked up. Someone posted this in the forum as a counter to Mills saying, oh look, Mills crowds are the best ever. I didn't see that this is from a year ago. So this is, yeah. So, yep, there you go. So apparently last year, the EFL were announcing 70-year high. This season, Millwall announced a 70-year high. So we got the effect maybe a bit delayed. So I didn't check that before I started recording. I'm not going to cut it out because I'm too lazy. So on that note, thank you for watching and goodbye.